if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
And yes, sir, that one drops. 37 points for Rhodes.
Boy, he's making it look really easy right now. I expect them to continue to run the offense through him until the defense changes plans.
Pau Gasol has checked in for the Bulls. Orlando leading by 7. To the wing on the left. Harkless the pass to Vucevic. Here's the Beast. Beyond the arc. Another miss by Orlando.
Tell you what, as well as he shot in the last quarter, Kevin, it's a total flip here in this one. He just can't get anything to go in the basket.
Easy call there.
No question about that one. You can hear the impact from where I am.
The free throw drops from McDermott.
2 shots.
And good on the second, so he makes them both.
Boy, that was solid. I tell you, he's one of the best there is up there at the foul line.
Look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. No good from the Beast.
Well, ever since the second half started, he's been ice cold. Very little going his way right now.
Rose gets a wide open look. Nailed from three-point land. Rose has got 40 points.
Second three-pointer of the half, fourth overall. So he's having a nice game from outside.
Harkless kicks to Vucevic. Poked loose. Fry, that's for 2. Drops one in from the wing. And the Magic lead by 4.
Bucket there, and I'll tell you what, that was an important shot.
Yeah, it sure was, Steve, because it stopped the bleeding a little bit. Now they've got something positive to hang their hat on.
Tobias Harris has checked in for Maurice Harkless. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Hi, guys. Over that break, I was able to catch the message Tom Thibodeau was giving to his team. He gave his guys the green light to keep firing from downtown, telling them, listen, I like the work you're doing out there. Keep finding those gaps on the perimeter. They're giving us open shots.
Rose, an easy 2 points on the layup. Rose has got 42 in the game. 1:36 left in the fourth. Here's the Beast. He's covered by Rose. Harris outside. Here's the Beast. A three-pointer, no good.
And I'll tell you what, this has been one ugly quarter for him.
And it keeps getting uglier. I mean, his touch has basically gone AWOL.
Rose with the ball. Now guarded by the Beast.
Ill-advised shot selection right there, Clark.
It really was. I mean, very low percentage shot there.
And Gasol comes to help. The Beast connects.
He's performing at such a high level. That's why they're in the lead right now.
Rose attacking the feed to Butler. And out of bounds as the Magic will gain possession. Magic shooting a respectable 47% from the field in this one. Here's the Beast. And the rebound goes to Pau Gasol.
Well, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Rose dishes to Butler. Puts it up from 12, and it comes off the front of the rim.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
That's his second personal foul.
The pass to Harris. There's the dish to Oladipo. Passes it to the Beast. For 3! And he gets the bucket. The Beast's got 59 points.
Well, that just adds to what's probably an already insurmountable lead. I think they'll be walking out of here with a pretty easy victory.
Steve, I think that's a given.
And again, no good by Chicago. Orlando's gotten some tough luck from three-point range. In the fourth quarter, they've hit just 1 of 6 from deep. From the arc. And he gets it to go. And now it's a 10-point Magic lead.
A serious game-clinching run. They've taken off here. Impressive.
And so it's Orlando taking this one by a big margin. Some days, Clark, everything goes right for a team, and they just had one of those games.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, these guys played a great all-around basketball game here.
Well, that'll do it. For
Okay, let's go over to the man on the aisle. What's your question?
You guys are rolling. Can you keep it up?
You better believe we can keep it up. Can't nobody play with us right now. We're men on a mission. And the rest of the league, some little boys. For real.
Okay, Kelly in front. What do you got?
Looking at the stat sheet, you took an awful lot of threes tonight. Any particular reason for that?
Well, they were giving me open looks, and I took them. Plain and simple. There's no need to look into it any deeper than that.
You, sir.
Everyone's talking about your little social media snafu. Care to comment?
No comment. I'd like to keep that private.
Private? That's a good one. Maybe you should have thought about that before blasting your intentions to lead the team to the universe.
You know what? You live and you learn, so let's move on.
Move on. To the next team, most likely.
Hey, listen. We're good. I spoke with the organization and the powers that be. We've decided to move on together. So, there's no story here. Stop fishing.
He's right. We're done here. Well done.
Thank you.
So with this social media scandal thing going, you've alienated your teammates, the fans, and management.
That wasn't my intention.
But that's what happened. That's why I keep an extra cell at home just for conversations I want to keep to myself. And that bad boy never leaves the house.
An extra cell?
Just keep your intentions to yourself. We're all disposable in this league. All I really care about is your mindset. How you feeling?
I feel good. I'm still focused on what matters. That's his team, my job, and the rest of the season.
Good, but words are one thing, actions are another. You're gonna have to bust your butt over the next few weeks to earn the respect and trust of your teammates again. Can you do that?
Absolutely, man. Those are my boys.
Good. Time to prove it. Now get out of here.
Yes, sir.
Hundreds of lakes dotting the city beautiful, Orlando, Florida. Welcome, everyone. This is what you've been waiting for. The NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This crowd is really ready to roar in this Eastern Conference matchup for the Magic. Last time they met was in Toronto, where they beat the Raptors. And guys, they had trouble finding a way to win the first two matchups, but they put together a nice win last time out and can tie things up here.
And it was the role players in that game, Kevin, that really led the charge. You know, the guys who normally don't score a lot, they came in and really contributed.
A total team performance, Steve, the kind you need if you're going to win on the opponent's home floor.
Here are the five for the Raptors. Lowry and DeRozan, they're the backcourt. Amir Johnson at the four with Valanciunas at the pivot. And it's Johnson in at the three, the small forward.
Valanciunas, a young big man with some offensive promise. He can score on the left block. He's developing a nice touch from mid-range. Very intriguing player with that size and skill set.
And here's Lowry after the three-pointer from the Beast, and he gets the bucket. Lowry's got his first bucket of the night.
And the layup just gift-wrapped right there. I mean, he had a clear path to the basket.
Launches it. Sticks another. Three more from the Beast. The Beast's got a couple of threes now in the first with the Magic. Now Lowry. Boy, he just disappeared against Charlotte, and they really needed him. Johnson, the pass to DeRozan. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. For Toronto, they come in off the loss to the Hornets.
They just couldn't get the ball in the basket that day, guys. No matter how many plays you make at the defensive end, hard to overcome such a lack of production offensively.
Yeah, the high-quality shots were few and far between for them, and they have nobody to blame but themselves. They need to work a lot harder to get good shots today.
Here's Lowry after the Magic pick up two. Let's the three fly. Count that one. Lowry's got five.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Hi, Kevin. I caught up with head coach Dwayne Casey. We talked about the keys in preparing for this game, and he said,